हाजीपुरी थी गई। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, अगेन यू ऑल आर वेलकम इन द सेशन ऑफ द इवेंट्स ऑफ मियोसिस। स्पेसिफिकली टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द इवेंट्स ऑफ मियोसिस इन द फर्स्ट फेज ऑफ फर्स्ट साइकिल। वी ऑल नो दैट मियोसिस इज द क्यूम्युलेटिवली summary of two cycles. First cycle will be here and second cycle will be here. So two cycles are there. In the each cycle there are the four phases are there. Just suppose P, M, A and P. So here also the PMAT will be there. P, then after M, A and at the last there will be the T. We have to remember one thing is there. If two time mitosis is repeated, just suppose one mitosis is occurred over here, second mitosis is occurred over here, then between these two mitosis there will be compulsory there will be the interphase over here. In the interphase the genetic material is get duplicated, but in the case of the meiosis it is again the two time mitosis. But between these two cell successive cycles, there isn't the interphase. The absence of the interphase will not allow the duplication of genetic material, and this genetic material is get not duplicated. So, as a result, only the half number of chromosomes are present after the division. Now, we will talk about the here are the four different phases: prophase one. Metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. In the same way, here in the second cycle, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2. So right now I am talking about the prophase 1 only. Right now I am talking about the prophase 1 only. If you are not getting my point, then so over here. Are you getting this in the wait a moment? See this? Okay, it is in the mirror image. Let me try to explain this thing. Just suppose we talk about the mitosis, then there are the only four phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. But just suppose we talk about the meiosis. Suppose over here I am talking about the meiosis. The meiosis have the eight phases. This prophase, metaphase, anaphase will be also there, and again the prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase will be there. So this prophase is known as the prophase one. This is the metaphase one. This is the anaphase one. This is the telophase one. Again, it is known as the prophase 2, it is the metaphase 2, and here is the anaphase 2 and telophase 2. Now, this all phases, prophase 2, metaphase 2, anaphase 2 and telophase 2 are exactly same as the mitosis. They have not any type of the difference. Whatever, so I am right now not considering it. So if we talk about this all four phases, if we talk about this all four phases that are in the first one, just suppose prophase one is there. Now this prophase one have the again four different, five different phases. Only prophase one have the five different phases. Metaphase is again the same just like it the mitosis, anaphase, telophase, everything will be exactly same except the Charmi, your class will be at the 12 o'clock. So right now you can left. Okay. We will meet tomorrow at the 12 o'clock. If we talk about the meiosis, in the case of the meiosis, there will be the 8 total phase. So this all 4 phase are known. This all 4 phase are known. These all 4 phases are known as the meiosis 1. These are known as the meiosis 1. And another, these all 4 phases are known as the meiosis 2. So if I am talking about the meiosis 1 and specifically about the prophase 1, then I have to explain leptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin and the diakinesis. So right now we will look about it. In the prophase 1 there will be leptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin and the diakinesis. So specifically with what exactly we want to learn, I am directly explaining that thing, and then after we will divide that knowledge. We will divide that knowledge into these 5 phases. So first of all, over here, what is happening? One chromosome is from the father. Just suppose here this both are, and one chromosome will be from the mother. So these 2 are from the father and 2 are from the mother. So you already know that there are the 22 autosomes. There are 22 autosomes and one sex chromosome is there. So if we talk about the one sex chromosome again, then this one sex chromosome will be in father and be from mother. So in the one cell only there will be 2 sex chromosomes. One will be from the father and one will be from the mother. Is it clear completely? Whatever I want to explain is clear right now. We just suppose we have the cell. Now in this cell there will be the 23 pairs. I mean, one pair is here, again one pair is the in the another color. Just suppose one pair is here in this color, again third one is here. So this type of the pairs will be there in this cell. So in this way total 23 pair will be there. Right in this figure only I have explained 4 pairs. So this, just suppose right now over here is the 23rd chromosome. This is the 23rd chromosome. So this both chromosomes, they have the similarities. This both have the similarities, and these similar chromosomes are known as the homologous chromosomes. These are known as the homologous chromosomes. So total 22 chromosomes will be homologous chromosome in the any cell. If we take the any cell, then there will be the 23 chromosomes, and this all chromosomes will be the homologous chromosome. So this type of the structure will be formed whatever shown in this figure. So here in this figure total 46 chromosomes, total 46 chromosomes are shown. Okay, still it is loading, so as it is get loaded we will focus on it. So the total number of chromosomes are shown. So this all will be are in the pair. So this both is known as the homologous chromosome, this both also will be known as the homologous chromosomes. Now, if we are pairing, just suppose here is the female cell. Okay. So female have the both XX. So both have the same similarity several in the several manners. So these are also known as the homologous chromosomes. But if there is not X chromosome and compared with the X, there is the Y chromosome, then in this type of the cases, it will be known as the heterologous. Heterologous chromosome, I am again going there. Just suppose here, this is the, this have also the shape of the X, but this is known as the Y. So if Y chromosome is there, then it is known as the heterologous chromosome. So I hope you have the idea of the heterologous and the homologous chromosomes. Now what is happening in these chromosomes? Just suppose homologous chromosomes are there. These homologous chromosomes first come together. So whatever the distance is shown over here will be lowered, and these chromosomes will come together. So this distance now will not be there. This chromosome exactly will come together. Then after, this both homologous chromosome will share several genetic material with each other. In which manner? Just suppose I have the I have the two ball pens and someone have the two pencils. Okay, so what is happening? I will share this ball pen to this one and I will take the pencils from here. So this is, this type of sharing will be there. I have, just suppose, two pen and someone have the two pencils. So what I will do? I will give my ball pen to him and oppositely I will take this pencil from him. So whatever this shown on this screen is the same thing. Here the one chromosome is sharing its red portion. One chromosome is sharing its red portion to the green one. So now this green chromosome have the red portion. Okay. And whatever here in this figure is not shown, just suppose here is the red chromosome. So now this red chromosome will have the, sorry, now this will have the green portion. So here will be the green portion. So this type of the exchanging is known as the genetic recombination. This type of exchange is known as the recombination. So now first what is happening? First these chromosomes come together, then after they will exchange their genetic material, and after that this both will be separated. Okay, so now this entire, or this all processes, whatever I have told right now, they will be performed in the only one phase of meiosis, and that phase is the prophase. So in the prophase, this everything is happening. Now there are the five stages of this prophase. So in the every one, there will be the little portion of the processes, and after that, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1 will be started as this process of the genetic recombination is completed. Now, to understand that thing, we have again the one still remaining something we have to understand. Here, the red color, whatever the red color is shown, is the one chromosome. Okay. Here in the red color, whatever shown is the only one chromosome. It is the one chromosome. And whatever shown in the gray color, it is the second chromosome. Here is the second chromosome that is shown in the gray color. Now this both have the chromatids. Mean during the replication, they made the another copy. So one chromatid is over here, second chromatid is over here. Again in the red color, one and second, these both are the chromatids, and chromosome is the histone. Okay, so whatever the ploidy of this cell, what will be the ploidy of this cell? The cell's ploidy will be diploid because it have the two chromosomes of same copy. Mean the homologous chromosomes are present over here, so it is the diploid cell. Now this both chromosomes will come together and it will extend its genetic material. So whatever the sister chromatids are there, they will be extending their genetic material. Okay, so these both are known as the bivalent chromosomes, and it is the whatever the junction is generated, it is known as the chiasmus. It is known as the chiasmus because the comma in the Latin words. Okay, they have the one alphabet. They have the one alphabet just like this shape. Okay. So it is known as the chiasmus. I think this it will be the clear about it. Now we have to focus on the every events form in the every pages. Just suppose we talk about the leptotin. So what is happening in the leptotin? So as we know right now, the cell is starting to enter into the meiosis. Okay. Yet this genetic material is not properly condensed. Yet the nuclear envelope is not break down. It is just initial phase. So in this initial phase, what is happening first? If you want to answer, you can answer. You can give me answer. What will be there in the first phase of leptotin? You already know that yet. Only the chromatin is there. Properly, chromatin is not being established properly. So first thing in the leptotin will be the just condensation. In the first phase, just will be the condensation of the genetic material. So here the chromosome just will be started to be formed. Okay, so they will appear in the leptotin. First phase of the meiosis, prophase one. Now in the second phase, it is the zygotin. In the case of the zygotin, what is going to happen is the starting of the synapses. Just synapses will be going to begin. Mean the initial steps of synapses are get started. So what is happening here? Some portion of the homologous chromosome are get come together. Okay. So it is the just portion is get initially started. It is the beginning of the synapses. Synapses mean to come together. It is the event of the zygotin. In the third one, pachytene. In the phase, pachytene exactly crossing over is formed. So crossing over is exactly the just like if you have the seen ever the train, okay, the rail of the train. I am just sharing my screen and I will show you how this is formed and why it is known as the crossing over. The more complex figure, so it will not allow just suppose over here. If I am copying this figure, so I can show you everything that I want. Just suppose train is there and it is coming on this rail. Here is the rail. So train is coming in, or the it is running on this rail. And just suppose here is the station, here is the railway station. And if this train want to come over here on this rail, then what it have to do? It have to change this rail by the crossing over. So this mechanism is known as the crossing over. So this both the rail will be get engaged, it is get binded with the another rail. So this type of the mechanisms are known as the crossing over. Just suppose the train is there and it is on this, just suppose over here, here is the train and it is coming in this direction. Can this train cross over? No. If it want to cross over, what it have to do? They have to share the rail in this way over here. Okay. So in this manner only it can be crossover. So in the same way this genetic material is get also crossover. So this crossing over is shown over here. So the genetic material is again crossover. Here the blue color is, here will be the there. Now this is the event of the pachytene phase. It is the event of the pachytene phase. After the pachytene phase we have the diplotene phase. Now what we are going to do, we are exchanging the genetic material properly. Okay. So at the last this both chromosome will start to separate. This both chromosome will start to separate, and if these chromosomes are start to separate, chiasma will be observed. First over here this chiasma will be started to be visible. What will be the chiasma? Just suppose one chromosome is over here. Another chromosome I am showing in the green color. So another chromosome will be over here. So these are the both chromosomes, they are already separated. So this will not be said as the chiasma. What chiasma will be said? Just suppose one chromosome is over here in this manner, and second one chromosome is there in the red color in this manner. So it is known as the chiasma if this both are still in the crossing over pattern. Okay, so chiasma will be visible now. I mean, we can see this chiasma in the microscope also. And in the last event of the diakinesis, what is happening? The nuclear membrane is now start to break down. I mean, still this nuclear membrane was there, it have not been break down. So whatever the chromosomal material is there, they are in the nucleus. So if I am asking you the one question, whatever the process of the crossing over are there, where this all processes are happening, then the answer will be the nucleus, not the cytoplasm, because this all events are formed in the only and only nucleus. Yes, so we have to remember these things. I hope you have got my point. Here the explanation of the word bivalent and what exactly chiasma is there. Okay. Here is the how these two cells are get connected and forming the zygote. Here is the one jaw. You have never said that there was the second anaphase. Okay, I mean the anaphase, this both the chromosomes are get separated, and this both have the not good feeling. They are just in the depression. Why we are get separating? Okay, so in the meiosis there are the two phases. I mean the two times the same chromosome is get separated, but in the mitosis only once. So thank you very much for your concentration.